Srishti, you inform other guys to join the class.
Yes, sir.
Still is there anyone to join? Srishti Dame.
I have messaged her, sir, but she's not online, sir.
Who?
I think Ankita, sir.
Okay, then we'll continue the class. Let her join later onwards. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I hope the screen is visible now. Okay guys, today we will discuss on the post-harvest management of flowers. We'll discuss in brief. Okay, in this aspect also you will get more than 5 to 10 questions, that too mainly regarding post-harvest management. Okay, that we will deal in detail here. Okay, voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, about 70% of potentially lasting flower, that cut flowers, are predetermined at the harvest. What its quality is predetermined and before the stage of harvest. Only the 30% or rest of the percentage can be maintained or enhanced during the post harvest management. Can we enhance the shelf life of cut flower or the loose flower or any flower or fruit? Can we enhance the shelf life?
Yes, sir.
How?
Sir, by pulsing solution.
Okay. Think logically. Can we enhance the shelf life of a produce or a product like flower or a fruit?
So is there difference between shelf life and base life?
Yeah, that's okay.
Generally, we don't increase.
Yes, we can't increase the shelf life or the life of any product. We can only maintain or we can only sustain that duration. For example, if the shelf life of a rose is considered 1 week or 1 month, this 1 week of cut flower, this rose we can maintain. We can't extend this 1 week to 1 month. Can we extend the shelf life? If it is
no, sir.
No, we can only preserve or we can only maintain that shelf life. We can't extend its lifespan. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then in post-harvest factors mainly influence the remaining 30%. Then about 30% of the fresh flowers are spoiled during the harvesting, handling and during the storage. This is the 30%, around 30% of the fresh flowers are, this is the post-harvest loss during the harvesting, handling and storage time. What is the average loss of horticulture produce in India? What is the post harvest loss?
Sir, so 40 to 45%, sir.
About 50% of the produce will be lost, spoiled in India. What is the post-harvest loss of horticulture produce in India? Yes? It should be always less than 10%, that too 4 to 5% only. Anyone of you know the exact number? What is the loss exactly that occurs in India? Recent data 2020.
Okay.
Okay. In the next class, you try to figure out what is the loss in India, post-harvest loss in India. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Insufficient light condition results the flowers with a low vase life. Besides, causes the bluing of petals and bent neck in roses due to formation of anthocyanins in the petals, insufficient lignification of neck region respectively. What is the major cause? The insufficient light condition. If we do not provide the good or optimum light condition, the flower's vase life will be affected. In some crops like roses, we can observe the bent neck or blowing of petals. What is the main reason for the blowing of petals in rose? Accumulation of ammonia or nitrogen. Have you heard of this blowing of this physiological disorder in rose? Blowing in rose, blowing of petals in rose. Write it down. Okay.
Okay.
Then what is the main reason for the bent neck? It is a disease or a disorder?
Disorder.
What is the reason? Reason of bent neck in rose?
Oxygen concentration.
That is in gladiolus. That too, that is spike. Here, bent neck. The bud size will be large, but the stalk is not having the that much strength to hold the big size bud. Why? What is the main reason? Insufficient lignification at the neck region. Means in the stalk at the region, neck region, the lignification is insufficient. Hence, it can't withstand the bud weight. That's why the bud will fall off like this. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then in Dahlia poinsettia, then Pepaver releases the latex upon cutting. To overcome this, they should be dipped in the hot water. Have you seen the Dahlia latex exudation after the flower harvest in poinsettia, in Pepaver, opium?
No,
no. I think you may have seen in Dahlia, Dahlia flower.
Flower,
yeah. After the harvest, the flower, the stems will exudate the latex, milky liquid. So in order to avoid that exudation, we are going to dip in the hot water. Hot water treatment. About 80 to 90 degrees Celsius hot water, we will dip for a few seconds. It will avoid the exudation. Okay. Then we will see the optimum stage of harvest for the particular crops. Have you read regarding the Alstroemer, Lily of Incas, this crop? This is a minor bulbous crop. At least you remember for which group it belongs. This is a bulbous crop or non-bulbous?
Yes, a bulbous.
It's a lily type. Lily belongs to lily group. Lilies are mainly bulbous. It possesses the underground bulbs. It's a tunicate or non-tunicate bulb? Quick. Tunicate or non-tunicate bulb? Lily bulb.
Tunicate.
Yes. Then this flower is harvested at the stage of 4 to 5 florets open. Mainly this lily will be in cluster. Have you seen the spider lily? It will bloom in the cluster. About 8 to 10 flowers will be there in one cluster. If about 4 to 5 florets are open, then we can go for the harvesting of this crop. This is the optimum stage of harvest. Then in Anthurium, about 1/3 of the true flowers on the spadix opens. And the spathe should be unfurled completely. Where are the true flowers in Anthurium?
In the spadix.
Yes. Spadix is the type of inflorescence in Anthurium. Consider this is the candle or inflorescence on which we will find the small true flowers. Consider it will going to open the flowers from the downwards to upwards. Okay, the flowers will open from this side. about 1/3. 1/3 flowers are open, and the spathe which is adjacent to the this paddocks, it should be unfold completely, then only we'll go for the harvesting in anthurium. Got it?
Yes.
Then in anthurium,
sir, how we come to know, sir, in paddocks we have not seen any flower, na? So 1/3 of two flowers open, how we came to know?
You haven't seen the anthurium flower?
Yes, I've seen in
then,
the picture.
Yeah, in the picture.
Yes.
No, you don't have the crop in your poly house, in your college or in the university or any other. Huh? Just quick. Is
no,
there
sir.
Or not?
No.
No. Okay, fine. You see, this is the Anthurium spadix. Okay, na?
Yes,
these are the tiny flowers. Okay, these are the tiny flowers on the anthurium. Here, if the flowers are opened, if the true flowers are opened, you will find the pollen spreading on the spadix. This is the spadix. Before the opening of the flowers, the spadix will be completely unfolded. Getting the point? Before the
yes,
opening of this small tiny flowers, this spathe, it will be completely open. Okay. Now you got the point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In anthurium, about 1/3 of the flowers should be opened. Have you seen the anthurium? This is also like
doctor.
Yes. It's also possess the spike inflorescence. In that inflorescence, 1/3 of the florets opened. Then we will go for the harvesting of anthurium. In calendula, fully opened flowers are harvested. In aster, when the outer row of disc florets shed the pollens, then we will go for the harvesting of asters. That too, the asters are mainly in India, will go for loose flower production. Then only we'll when the flower is completely opened and the disc florets shed the pollen, it is the optimum stage for the local market. Okay, remember this one. Then in Cattleya orchid, in all the orchids, mainly. What will when we'll harvest in the orchids? Yes, when we'll
after opening.
When we'll harvest in the orchids?
Fully open stage, sir.
Okay, mainly in the orchids we'll find the spike. Okay, there are n number of flowers, more than 20-30 flowers will be there in the inflorescence. If we wait till all the flowers are fully developed and completely open, then the complete the spike will be wasted. In this picture you can observe the lower petals, the lower florets are completely opened and the upper florets are they are in bud stage. This is the condition in Dendrobium orchid. In all orchids, mainly the lower 3 to 4 florets, when they are completely open, then we will go for harvesting. Getting the point?
Yes.
Here also you can find when the lower florets also completely open, they are in still bud stage. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then when to harvest the orchids? Mainly during 4 to 5 days after the complete opening of lower florets. Okay, or fully opened flowers except top buds. Getting? Then
yes,
in
sir.
Chrysanthemum, mainly in Chrysanthemum, that too in standard type, when we will going to harvest? When the outer ray florets fully expand, then we will go for the harvesting of Chrysanthemum for the cut flower. When the outer ray florets are fully expanded, means the disc will be completely, the disc florets, it not unfurled, means it not completely developed at this stage. They are in still developing stage. The outer ray florets are completely developed and expanded. At that stage, we'll go for harvesting of Chrysanthemum for cut flowers. But in case of spray type, when the florets, when the all the flowers, when the flowers open, completely open, but before shedding of pollen, we'll go for harvesting in Chrysanthemum. Getting the point? What is the difference between cut and spray? When to harvest both? In spray?
Sir, in spray type here, disc florets are not completely developed, but partially developed.
No. I'll show you in the picture. Wait. In the spray type, the all the flowers will be opened. You consider this is the spray type of Chrysanthemum. Here in this picture you observe all the flowers has been completely opened, but the disc florets yet not shredded their pollen. If the florets are shred released the pollen, means it is already over matured. The flower has been over matured. Before the shedding of the pollen, we will go for harvesting in spray type of Chrysanthemum. Getting? Yes?
Yes, sir. Yes,
here, here you consider. Consider this is the cut flower. The only outer ray florets are completely developed and expanded. The inner disc florets still they are in budded stage.
Underdeveloped.
Yeah, underdeveloped. At this stage we will go for harvesting of cut flowers. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then in pompom and decorative type of Chrysanthemum, the center of the oldest flowers are fully open. Here also, this is also like spray type, but here the center oldest flowers will be fully opened. At that stage we will go for the harvesting. Mainly we will in the group we'll have different type of what do you call different number of more number of flowers will be there in the decorative type. Here the main central, this central bud is fully opened, means then we will go for the harvesting. It is also like spray type. Got it?
So please repeat once again, sir. Pompon and decorative.
Pompon and decorative type. You see here it will also contains cluster of flowers. Okay, when the central bud is fully open and other buds will be in bud stage, not fully open, at that stage we have to go for harvesting of pompon type or decorative type of Chrysanthemum. Got it?
Yes,
it will be in cluster. That's why when the central bud is fully open, at that time we'll go for the harvesting of decorative type Chrysanthemum. They won't ask this decorative and anemone, they will mainly ask the standard type and spray type. Then in dahlia, when all the flowers are completely opened, we'll go for harvesting. In carnation, Carnation also in cut flower, the paint bud stage, the paint brush stage is the optimum stage of harvesting of chrysanth carnation, that too for cut flower. Okay. For the spray type, at least two flowers are fully open, then we will go for harvesting of carnation.
So please identify the flower, sir. Matlab, show the flower.
Have you seen the carnation in your campus?
Yes, I see.
Okay. Carnation paint brush stage. Yes, this is the stage of harvest. Getting? This is the correct stage for the cut flower.
Sir, 1, 2, 3 for any stage we can harvest?
No. Have you seen the paintbrush? The pencil paintbrush?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
How it will be? Whether it is in first stage, second or third stage?
So like third stage.
Third stage. Right?
Yes.
This is the stage. This is the correct stage for harvesting of carnation. Then in freesia, when the buds are in colored stage, then we'll go for harvesting of this flower. In gerbera, fully open, but the outer row disc florets are yet not started the pollen. The flowers will be completely opened, but the pollen is yet not shredded. At this stage, we'll go for harvesting of gerbera. In gladiolus also, mainly 1 to 5 florets shown color. I'll show the pic. When to harvest gladiolus, mainly the lower florets show the color. At that stage, we'll go for harvesting. This is the correct stage of harvesting of gladiolus. You are getting the lower florets showing the color, clear color, and they are in bud stage, the upper florets. Right? Then in gypsophila, when the flowers
are completely we harvest it.
Yeah, it is a spike.
Yes, sir.
We'll remove from the bottom.
Yes, sir.
Then in gypsophila, when the flowers are just open, at that stage we'll go for harvesting. Iris also, when the buds are colored, we'll go for harvesting. In lilium also, this is important. Narcissus or daffodil, what is the correct stage of harvesting? Have you seen the narcissus, daffodil flowers? Huh?
No, sir.
Goose neck stage. It is used for the loose flower or cut flower? Huh?
Loose, maybe.
Maybe?
Loose.
Maybe for the loose flower. This is also used for the cut flower. This is mainly the bulbous plant.
Yes.
Goose neck stage. This is the optimum stage for the harvesting of daffodils. Daffodil is the national flower of which country?
Daffodil, New Zealand.
No, China. This is very important crop, daffodil. The main questions will be the correct stage, the gooseneck stage is the harvesting stage of which among the following crop, or the national flower of China is daffodil or narcissus. Then in tuberose, for the single type, the fully developed and unopened buds are harvested. Here also it's also like spike. The lower florets will be fully developed and upper will be unopened buds. In double, When the maximum flow rates are open, at that stage we'll go for harvesting. Then in rows, mainly during the tight bud stage, in the rows, tight bud stage, in the bird of paradise, when the first flow rate is completely opened. In tulips, mainly off-colored buds are harvested in tulips. In zinnia, fully opened flowers are harvested. Okay. Then we'll see some of the important terminologies, concepts. Have you heard of this turbid water? After the harvesting of flower. Yes. After the harvesting of flower in the palios, the phloem will be exposed to air, and those vacuum places will be occupied by the air. And if we go for the pre-cooling or conditioning of the flower in the controlled environment, if we keep or impregnated in the water, this water will displaces the air in the xylem vessel. This water we call turbid water. Got it?
So is there any picture about this topic?
After you consider the Gerbera. Have you seen the Gerbera cut stem?
Yes, sir.
How it looks? It will be hollow, na? The Gerbera,
yes,
stem will be hollow. After cutting, the stems are exposed to air. At that time, what will happen? Those xylem vessels will be filled with the air vacuum. Okay. If we dip the stems in the waste solution or conditioning solution or in the pre-cooling water, then those air molecules will be replaced by these water molecules. That water we call turbid water. Okay.
So it is only in case of Gerbera?
No, in all the cut flowers.
Achha.
Yeah. Then floral preservative means it is mainly any chemical formulation which is useful for extending the shelf life or waste life of flowers. Any chemical which extends the shelf life or waste life is called floral preservative. Then we have different types of floral preservative, mainly the pulsing solution. What do you mean by pulsing solution? It's for long term or short term duration. Pulsing is done before harvest. Sorry, before shipment or after shipment, we'll go for pulsing.
After shipment?
No, before we go for the shipment of flowers, this pulsing is done, that too short duration, maybe 16 to 24 minutes. Less than that only we will go for pulsing. This is pre-storage treatment. Before we going for the storage or for the shipment, we'll do pulsing for the short term. Okay. The effect of this pulsing treatment will last throughout our entire waste life of the flower. Then this sucrose is the main component in pulsing solution. This is important. Which is the main component in pulsing solution? Sucrose. This is expected question. Then hence it is a short term treatment with a high level of sucrose under the light condition. This is also very important. Short duration, mainly sucrose will be the component. Okay, sucrose will be the main component in the pulsing solution, that to higher level, done before shipment and before storage. This is called pulsing. Getting?
Yes.
Then what do you mean by bud opening solution? When we will follow the bud opening solution treatment, mainly when we harvest the immature buds. When we harvest the cut flowers, that in immature bud stage, then we will go for the bud opening solution. That the chemical solutions are used for inducing the opening of buds. Here we will mainly use the lower concentration of sucrose, that to 4% only. This is what we term bud opening solution. Low concentration of sucrose in order to open the buds of the flowers. Got it? Then what do you mean by holding or waste solution? What do you mean by that?
Extend waste leaves.
Okay. Mainly this waste solution mainly we'll use in when we keep in the storage, or holding solution mainly we'll use in the during the storage. Waste solution we'll mainly use in the when we keep in any exhibition or in the flower arrangement or in the table tops, then we will go for the use of waste solution mainly to hold the flowers continuously till it terminate its waste life. Here mainly the low level of sucrose is used. Here we will supply the sucrose in order to respire or in order to continue its metabolic activities, so that the life of the flower is there during the storage or during the flower arrangement or during the decoration type. At that time only we will go for the waste solution use. Okay. Then we will see what are the main constraints.
Sir, difference between sir pulsing solution and waste solution, sir.
Yes, you should explain what is the difference between the pulsing solution and waste solution. Here mainly we use lower concentration of sugar. Here
yes,
mainly we use higher concentration of sucrose.
Yes, sir.
This is mainly done during the after the storage or during the storage or after the storage or during the decoration. At that time we will go for use of waste solution. This is mainly done during pre-shipment. Yeah, pre-shipment or pre-storage time. That too for short duration. This is for long duration. This is also important difference. They may give the this type of statements in assertion and reasoning type. The pulsing solution or the pulsing treatment is done for the short duration of time before pre-storage. And second statement will be the holding solution or the waste solution. Waste treatment is mainly done after the storage or during the storage at the higher concentration of sucrose. Then the second statement will be wrong. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's why you need to keenly learn the concepts so that you will easily differentiate both the differences and you can easily figure out which is the correct answer. Then in the next concept we will discuss the main constraints in the floral preservatives, mainly the water, sugar, biocides, chemicals. These are will be the main components. Coming to water, mainly this tap water will be harmful in the if you use the tap water in the floral preservation solution. This will be harmful. Why? Because the tap water usually contains high pH and it also contains the more total dissolvable solids and maybe some toxic ions like sodium. Sodium is toxic for which of the cut flower? Rose, gerbera, chrysanthemum, carnation. Quick.
Gerbera, sir.
Then? Any other option? sodium ions are toxic for roses also. Okay, then what is the optimum TDS level should be in the water for any irrigation of for any irrigating water or water which is used in the floral preservative? It should be always less than 200 ppm. You should remember this one. It should be always less than the 200 ppm. TDS should be. This is the general agri question. Have you read regarding the general agri concepts?
Yes.
Then what should be the minimum level of TDS, total dissolvable salts, should be there in the irrigation water, irrigating water? Yes, quick. It should be
less than 100 ppm.
Less than
100.
Less than 200 ppm. Okay.
Okay.
Then the high pH will reduce the waste life. Acidifying water to the lower pH is also advantageous as it decreases the microbial culture. At the acidic condition, mainly the fungal activity will be hindered. In the basic condition or in the alkaline condition, the fungal activity will be hindered. Is it true or false?
Sir, in acidic, fungal activity is there, sir.
Is there. In basic?
Yes. Basic fungal activity is not there.
Yes. I said exactly opposite. Like that, the question will be appeared in the assertion and reasoning type of questions. Getting the point?
Yes, sir.
If we use the water which has the lower pH, it has some advantage that it will decreases the microbial activity in the water. Okay. But the use of tap water is harmful in the waste life, waste solution or the floral preservative solutions. Then in the sugar, sugar also provides the food. After the harvest, how can the cut flower will survive? By artificial feeding of sugars. We are going to supply the sugars during the life of flower in the plant. The photosynthesis will be produced in the plant. Mainly it will get the glucose from the leaves. But after the harvest, mainly we are going to provide the sugar artificially. This sugar will yield the energy for the cut flower to for its metabolic activities like respiration, transpiration. Those are all the minimum activities to be done by a flower in order to live. That's why we need to provide the sugar after the harvest in order to survive the, in order to see the flower in a healthy condition. Okay. But one more problem is, if we provide the food, if we provide the sugar in the preservative solution, it will promote the microbial growth. Is it not? That's why only we will use the biocides, chemicals. So these microorganism load will be reduced in the preservative solution. In spite of the use of chemicals, the microbial load will be present in the preservative solution. Okay. Then biocides. What do you mean by biocides? Bio, life. Side means the agent which destroys the life.
Yes.
Mainly used for the inhibiting the microbial growth in the waste water as well as in the stem surface. The important biocides are like 8-HQC, silver nitrate, aluminium sulfide, citric acid, slow releasing chlorine compounds and quaternary amino salts. These are all the, some of the important examples which are used in the floral preservative. What do you mean by 8-HQC? Expand 8-HQC. This is the important biocide used in all the type of floral preservative. Yes, what do you mean by 8-HQC? Expand 8-HQC.
Sir, hydroquinone and chlorine.
Yes, hydroquinone, chloride, exactly. Then silver nitrate, alum. Then have you heard of STS, silver thiosulfate? This has been banned due to its cancerous activity. Then mainly the chlorine releasing compounds are used. Then ammonium salts. These ammonium salts are mainly harmful for the any organisms. It's also harmful for the microbes, plants, humans, all of them. Ammonium salts also been used in the where? In the explosives. Right?
What, sir?
Ammonium salts mainly used in explosives. Right or not? Huh? Who is the ammonium nitrate? Who is the scientist who discovered this ammonium based explosives? He got the Nobel Prize. Huh? Have you heard of who is that scientist? Alfred Nobel.
Yes, sir.
In the memory of his name only, they are giving the Nobel Prize. Initially, during the World War, he only figured out the ammonium nitrate, how this can be manipulated as an explosive. Okay, after that, he got a huge reputation in the World War time. Then, after that, thousands, lakhs together people died, but he got huge money in return, but he suffered a lot. That's why he donated all his money for the foundation for the cause of peace in the world, in the remembrance of this birthday. They are giving the this prize, Nobel Prize, every year. Okay, Alfred?
Yes.
Nobel. You should remember the important scientists who are getting the Nobel Prize in the biology. Okay, who are the main scientists who got the Nobel Prize from India, Indian scientist recently? This will be the general questions they will cover definitely in the examination.
Sir, okay. Abhijit Binayak Bandhupad.
Okay, recently Abhijit Banerjee.
Yes.
He is from?
West Bengal.
For his work on economics.
Economics.
He did his PhD in the Bombay University. This was the question for us. Not for us, maybe for our juniors. The Nobel Peace Awardee, Abhijit Banerjee from India. He got the Nobel Prize for his work on economics. Then where he was pursuing the his PhD. For his PhD only he got the Nobel Prize. Okay, where he was pursuing his PhD. They asked the question like this from the Bombay University. Okay, these are also you should cover. Then silver thiosulfate. Mainly, this is widely used chemical in order to inhibit the ethylene production in cut flowers. This ethylene is the main culprit in cut flower. It will reduce the waste life or shelf life. Now it is banned due to heavy metal toxicity. Now it is being banned, but it is mostly widely used chemical in the floral preservative. Then conditioning. What do you mean by conditioning? Yes, quick. After the shipment, the flowers will be in stress. So, in order to condition the flowers, these flowers will be treated with the demineralized water with the germicide and citric acid. They have been a lot of respiration, transpiration during the shipment process. Hence, the loss of minerals will be there. During the transpiration, the minerals will be lost in the flower. So,
yes.
In order to demineralize the water, demineralize the cut flower, we'll use the special treatment called conditioning. They may also ask, the conditioning is referred to demineralized water treatment. Okay. Then impregnation.
Okay.
What do you mean by impregnation? Impregnation means dipping of cut flower into the preservative solution. Mainly done nickel chloride or calcium chloride for the 10 to 15 minutes to prevent the microbial growth. Then calcium in the form of, what is this? CaNO3 twice. Calcium nitrate or what?
Calcium nitrate.
Calcium nitrate, calcium chloride, calcium carbide is reported to increase the waste life of cut flower by decreasing the membrane permeability, delaying the senescence and modification of the action of plant hormone. These plant hormones will be the main culprit. They will reduce the waste life. Then senescence. Then membrane permeability. These are all the main reason. These are all the natural reason why the shelf life will be reduced in the cut flower after the harvest. So these calcium based chemicals will improve the shelf life. Okay, this aluminium sulfate also found to reduce the petal pH to stabilize the anthocyanin of petals due to acidifying holding solution to reduce the fungal and bacterial growth. Aluminium sulfate. Then copper sulfate also used as a germicide in holding solution. Then these benzoates, carbonic acid, mainly used as antioxidants. It will scavenge the free radicals present in the flowers. Then aspirin. This is the trade name, aspirin. Acetyl salicylic acid is the chemical name. This is mainly used as antitranspirant. Antitranspirant. Why they are used in cut flowers?
Sir, if transpiration occurs, then shelf life will be reduced.
Okay. Which are all the other chemicals used as a antitranspirant?
Sir, acetic acid.
Okay. Abscisin, abscisic acid.
Acetic acid.
Abscisic acid. This is a natural transparent in the plant system. Apart from this,
yes.
You should focus on these type of questions. Crop physiology, antitranspirants. I feel you haven't read regarding the crop physiology, general agriculture. You should cover little bit. Daily half an hour you read regarding the general agriculture. Okay.
Yes,
apart
sir.
From the aspirin, abscisic acid also the natural antitranspirant in the plant. Okay. Then AOA, AVG, MVG, 1-MCP. These are all,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
These are all ethylene inhibitors.
Inhibitors.
Have you heard of these chemicals?
Yes, sir.
What is the main action of AOA? Amino acetic acid. Amino oxyacetic acid, amino ethoxy vinyl glycerin, methyl vinyl glycerin. You should remember this chemical name. These are all the natural components in the ethylene biosynthesis pathway. Okay, 1-MCP, 1-methanol cyclopropane. Okay, these are all the main ethylene inhibitors. What do we call the ethylene biosynthesis pathway? What is the terminology? Who given the ethylene biosynthesis pathway? Yes, quick.
Forgot the name, sir.
Huh? Who is a scientist?
Forgot it.
Have you heard of Yang cycle? Yang, Y-A-N-G.
No, sir.
Yang cycle. He is a scientist, man, who given the ethylene biosynthesis pathway. This is very important. Okay, you remember this one. Y-A-N-G, Yang. Yang cycle, ethylene biosynthesis pathway. Okay, these are all the important chemicals used as a ethylene inhibitor. Right?
Yes.
Which is the in the tomato we have one technology. What do you call that? We have a hybrid, genetically modified hybrid. We have silenced one gene. Maybe? Yes, flavor saver. Oh, what do you call that technology used for the genetic engineering? Yes? Yes, have you heard of RNA silencing technology? RNA gene silencing. In that technology, we are going to silence particular gene or the particular, what do you call that? Triploids or what do you call that? Purines or pyrimidines, which code for the particular enzyme or the compound. We are going to silence that. So in tomato hybrid flavor saver, we silence the component, we silence the gene which responsible for the ethylene production in the plant. So what is the advantage of that? The tomato will have the more shelf life after the harvest. Also the ethylene won't produce in the tomato. Got it? Remember that hybrid. Then the gaseous compound 1-MCP methyl cyclopropane is very effective ethylene inhibitor. The flower should be treated with a lower concentration, preferably 2 to 3 ppb parts per billion. This is a very important and effective ethylene inhibitor, mainly used in the floral preservative. Then naturally this ethylene is the culprit for the senescence of flowers. Not for the flowers, but also for the fruit, seed, plant, any part of the plant. The ethylene is the main culprit. Then ethylene toxicity causes the sleepiness in carnation, epinosti in poinsettia. This is very important. Poinsettia and carnation are ethylene sensitive. Getting the point? They may ask different ways. The different ways of asking the question in your exam. But you remember ethylene, this carnation and poinsettia are ethylene sensitive crops. Then oxygen scavengers are ferrous oxide. Oxygen scavengers means mainly used in the post harvest, maybe in the waste solution or maybe in the packaging material. They will use the ferrous oxide in order to scavenge or destroy the CO2. It will absorb the O2, oxygen. So if we won't provide the oxygen for the produce, means it won't respire. It won't respire means the metabolic activities will be very low. So automatically the shelf life will be increased. Shelf life will be maintained. Then CO2 scavengers means these are all the compounds. They will absorb the carbon dioxide, mainly calcium hydroxide. This will causes the off flavor development in the post harvest. This is mainly the CO2 scavengers mainly used in the packaging material. That too, like we'll go for the modified vacuum packaging, modified atmospheric packaging. At that time only we'll use the CO2 scavengers. Then CO2 emitters, ascorbic acid. Why we need to use the CO2 emitters? Because in the atmosphere, if the CO2 concentration is more, the O2 concentration is less, it will create the modified atmospheric condition. Then the the product will respire very respire at the lower rate. Then we can extend, then we can maintain the shelf life of the produce. Okay, then have you heard of ethylene scavengers?
Yes.
Where it is used mainly? This potassium permanganate. This potassium permanganate, activated carbon, activated charcoal, where it is all mainly used in the export of grapes. What do you call that specific products? Ethylene scavenger. Have you heard of grape guard? Grape guard. Yes, potassium. Yes. Your voice is breaking. I feel you are saying regarding the grape guard, mainly use potassium permanganate, right? In order to scavenge the ethylene evolved during the respiration of grapes, right? Then we'll see some of the flowers which are very sensitive to ethylene, mainly the Alstroemia, Antirrhinum, orchids, lilies, carnation, Delphridium, sweet pea, Gypsophila. This will be the definite question in your exam. Which among the following crop is ethylene sensitive? They will mainly target on Alstroemia, Antirrhinum, then Carnation, Delphridium, then maybe Gypsophila. These are all the very frequently asked options. Then which are all insensitive to ethylene? Insensitive means this Anthurium, Gerbera, Chrysanthemum, Gladiolus, Tulip and Rose. These are all very insensitive to ethylene. Then you need to remember these two types, two conditions also. Then there are two types of flowers depending on respiration rate, mainly the climatic flowers and non-climatic flowers. What do you mean by climatic? Exactly. Here in this type of flowers we will observe the sharp rise in the respiration peak, and the flower opening will be continue after the harvest also. This is very important. We'll observe the respiration peak and also flower will continue to open after the harvest also. Examples like carnation, jasmine, petunia, Torania. These are all the example. These are the climatic flowers. If we harvest the paint carnation at the paint brush stage also, it will going to open the flower, right? If we harvest the jasmine at the evening time also, mainly the women will harvest the jasmine buds during the evening time. They will tie at the night and they will keep in the cooler region. Then in the morning hours, while they are going for the office, they will adore for the hairs. At that time the flower will be completely opened. I think you have seen in your house, your mother, sister, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then non-climatic flowers means here we doesn't show any respiration spike and flowers fail to open after the harvest. Mainly this tulip, Heliconia, Dendrobium orchid. If you given the additional ethylene also, these flowers won't respond for the ethylene. They won't open the flowers. That's why we have to harvest these flowers when they are in fully opened stage. Then most of the cut flowers are pre-cooled by forced air cooling method. Okay. I think we took more than 1 hour class, right?
Yes, sir.
You have any doubts, queries, or points to add for this discussion? You are free now.
What do scavengers, you to scavengers means?
What do scavengers means?
Yes.
What do observers? They will observe the oxygen in the atmosphere. Consider we have packed the rose cut flowers in the CFC box. There we in the outer layer of the CFC box we pasted the ferrous oxide. What it does? It will absorb the all the oxygen in that box. What will happen if it absorbs all the oxygen in that atmosphere?
Respiration.
Yeah, the flowers feels we have low amount of oxygen, so we need to reduce our metabolic activity so that we can withstand, so that we can survive. This is how we taken the advantage of exploiting the cut flowers. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, any other doubts?
No.
Okay, if it is the case, then we'll close the meeting. We'll see you tomorrow. Right?
Yes, sir.